AI, who has given all of us an opportunity to be part of this session, and especially I would like to thank to give me a chance as moderator. It's my pleasure to walk you through the webinar and introduce you to the speakers and all the attending through Facebook Live all across the country to gain the knowledge and enhance the mental horizon. Dr. Samta Soni, today's speaker, is having 27 years of experience in nursing. Madam is working presently as assistant lecturer in Government College of Nursing, Jaipur. Madam has completed Master of Nursing in Community Health Nursing from Jivaji University in 2009 and completed PhD from Dr. K. N. Modi University, Rajasthan in 2016. Madam has several lifetime membership and is an active member of TNAI, Society of Community Health Nurses of India, Society of Midwives India, Safety Personnel of India, Innovative Alliance for Public Health, Founder President Society of Public Health Education, Research and Empowerment. Madam has gained many academic and administrative achievements such as mentor for undergraduate and postgraduate, which served her well while supervising junior nursing student who approached her for advice and guidance. Madam has also worked as coordinator of MSc nursing program, participated in course management meetings and curriculum development, raising issues on behalf of student nurses. She has also organized state level workshop of MSc nursing on stress management. She has been a chairperson for scientific committee in 75th biannual TNAI national conference. She has also organized 3 state level workshops for Society of Midwives India. Madam has also been organizer of first national conference of Innovative Alliance for Public Health. In her achievement part, Madam has written many books in nursing, such as National Health Planning, Textbook of Advanced Nursing Practice, Textbook of Community Health Nursing, and Fundamental of Nursing. Madam is also a chief editor of journalnursing.com. In the next hour of session, Dr. Samta Soni ma'am will be walking you through what the webinar topic is about, how useful it is for you, and what does the future hold for all of us in the context of the theme. Madam will be sharing her thoughts, knowledge, and opinion with rest of us on the theory of Martha E. Rogers, Science of Unitary Human Being. Now I request Dr. Samta Soni ma'am to carry with her presentation.
Madam. Thank you, Mukesh ji. Thank you very much for the lovely introduction of mine. And first of all, before starting my session, I would like to thank you, NTAI, for the fantastic organization of Theories web series, which will be very useful for the nursing students pan India. So thank you, Mr. Farooq, and your team to organize such a wonderful and learnable and knowledgeable session on theories of nursing. Thank you very much. So I would like to start my presentation today with the brief introduction of Miss Martha Roser. So in this presentation, I would like to cover the following criteria with this background of theories, introduction of theory, major concept and definitions given by the Martha Rosers, 10 principles of theory, major assumptions of Martha Rosers' theory, meta paradigm in nursing and application of theory in nursing, and some references which I refer. So Martha Rosers said, the practice of nursing is not nursing, rather it is the use of nursing knowledge of human betterment. Background, Martha Roser, born on 12th May 1914, and her early life, Martha Roser was born on 12 May 1914. She was an American nurse, researcher, theorist, and author widely known for developing the science of unitary human being. In short, we are knowing that SUHB. And landmark book is An Introduction to the Theoretical Basis of Nursing, which will be a milestone for the future nursing. And She believes that a patient can never be separated from his or her environment when addressing health and treatment. Coexistence of the human and his or her environment contributed a lot in the process of change toward better health. About her education, initially Martha Rogers wanted to do something that would hopefully contribute to like laws and medicine. But instead, Rogers entered a local hospital that had a school of nursing. And she had a diploma from Kongsville General Hospital School of Nursing in 1936. And her graduation in public health nursing from George Peabody College in 1937. She also having MA in Teachers College, Columbia University in New York in 1945. And later she did MPH from John Hopkins University, Baltimore in 1952. She also having doctorate in nursing from John Hopkins University, Baltimore 1954. And the position of after the PhD, professor at Division of Nursing, New York University and consultant speaker. So, her career after graduated from college in Tennessee in 1937, she worked for the Children's Fund of Michigan for 2 years as public health nurse. And in 1940, she accepted a position in Hartford City at the Visiting Nurse Association. She worked at the association for 5 years as assistant supervisor, assistant education director, and director of education. Her publication are Theoretical Basis of Nursing, published in 1970, Nursing Science and Art, a Prospective in 1988, Nursing Science of Unitary Irreducible Human Being Update in 1990, and lastly, Vision of Space-Based Nursing in 1990. So, about her awards and honors, Martha Rogers was honored with the numerous awards and citations for her sustained contribution to nursing and science. So before indulging into theory, I would like to ask Titesh ji how much time you are giving to me so I can make my speed. How much time I'm having?
Ma'am, you have 50 minutes.
Okay. Thank you so much. So, about the theory, Martha Rogers' theory is known as SUHB, or Science of Unitary Human Being. The theory views nursing as both a science and an art. That is, provide a way to view the unitary human being who is integral with the universe. The unitary human being and his or her environment are one, only one. And nursing focuses on principle and manifestations that emerge from the mutual human environmental field process. As we all know, environment is all totally affected human beings. In case we are having the good environment, we are feeling good. And in case we are having bad environment, likewise, these days of COVID era, we are not feeling very much good. So addressing the importance of the environment as an integral part of patient, the uniqueness of nursing, like any other science, it is in the phenomenon central to its focus. The purpose of nurses is to promote health and well-being for all persons wherever they are. The development of Rogers' abstract system was strongly influenced by an early grounding in arts as well as background in science and interest in space. The science of unitary human being began as a synthesis of ideas and facts. So there are two dimensions according to the Martha Rogers of nursing. This is science of nursing, which is knowledge specific to the field of nursing that comes from the scientific research. And the second dimension is art of nursing, which involves using the science of nursing creatively to help better the life of patients. So according to the Martha Rogers, nurses have to use their knowledge in the field of nursing, which is evidence-based. Today we are frequently use the term evidence-based. And art of nursing, we are using nursing science as creatively for the help the patient, which is either in indoor or in outdoor, to make her or his life better. So some assumptions given by Martha Rogers are wholeness, like human being is considered as united whole. And then openness, a person and his environment are continuously exchanging energy with each other, person and his environment. And unidirectionality, the life process of human being involved irreversibly and unidirectional, likewise from birth to death. Pattern and organization is the next assumption from the Martha Roser, which define the pattern, identify individuals and reflect their innovative wholeness. And the last one assumption is sentence and thought, which is human are only organism able to think, imagine, and have language. So assumptions in detail, main is unified whole, possessing his own integrity and manifesting characteristics that are more than and different from the sum of his parts. Man and environment are continuously exchanging matter and energy with one another, and the life process evolves irreversibly and unidirectionally along the space-time continuum. Pattern organization identify the man and reflect his innovative wholeness. And lastly, man is characterized by the capacity for abstraction and imagery, language and thought, sensation and emotions. So there are 8 concepts in Martha Roser's theory. One is openness. One by one, we will discuss about all the concepts. So in the short, openness, energy field, pan-dimensionality and pattern are 4 principles, and integrality, helicity and resonance in another concept in the theory of Martha Roser. So these major concept is energy field, openness, pattern and pan-dimensionality. So what is energy field? So the energy field is the fundamental unit of both living and non-living organisms on the earth. And this energy field provides a way to perceive people and environment as irreducible wholes. And the energy field continuously varies in intensity, density and extent. So every time when man or human being interact with the environment, the energy field continuously varies according to intensity, density and extent, and it is an inevitable part of life. And human and environment both have energy field which is open. And for example, energy can freely flow between human and the environment, and we consider oxygen as a main energy. Oxygen is providing energy to human. So when we are in the high altitude areas where oxygen is less, so we are not feeling very well and not having energy. So energy is the main flow of oxygen is the main flow of energy. And the next concept of Martha Roser's theory is openness. The human field and the environmental field are constantly exchanging their energy. There are no boundaries or barriers that inhibit energy flow between fields. So this is a continuum process flowing of energy between human and environment. And there are no boundaries that stop energy flow between the human and environmental field, which is the openness in Roser's theory. It refers to qualities exhibited by open system. Human being and their environment are open systems, and it can lead to the continuous movement or matter of energy. And there is no process of osmosis and all where high concentration and low concentration are matter from the flow, but in the field of energy, there are no boundaries, there are no barriers in the flow of energy from human to environment or environment to human. Then the next concept is pattern. Pattern is defined as the distinguishing characteristics of an energy field perceived as a single wave. And pattern is an abstraction and it gives identity to the field. So when we discuss the application of this theory, I will tell you how the pattern will affect the patient. Then the last concept is pan-dimensionality. Pan-dimensionality is defined as non-linear domain without spatial or temporal attributes, and human being are pan-dimensional being and one more than 3 dimensions. So Martha Roser consider human as the human being which is having more than 3 dimensions. So parameters that human uses in language to describe events are arbitrary. And the present is relative. There is no temporal ordering of lives. So in the abstraction, pan-dimensionality means human being are having more than three dimension of their existence. Then principles, some principles of hemodynamics are, hemodynamic refer to the balance between dynamic life process and environment. And Martha Roses fantastically used this principle in her theory, the principle of hemodynamic postulate the way of perceiving unitary human being. Three principles of hemodynamics, resonancy, helicity, and integrality. So first we will discuss the principle of resonance. Resonance is an order arrangement of rhythm characterizing both human field and environmental field that undergoes continuous dynamic metamorphosis in the human environmental process, and it is speak to the nature of change occurring between human and environmental fields. And the life process in human being is a symphony of rhythmical vibrations oscillating at various frequencies. So the diagram depicts the resonance, what means. And it is in the life process, it is symphony of rhythmical variations oscillating the various frequencies. Second principle, a hemodynamic principle is helicity. Helicity describes the unpredictable but continuous non-linear evolution of energy field that evidenced by non-repeating rhythmicities. And the principle of helicity postulates an ordering of human evolutionary emergence. Human environmental field is a dynamic open system in which change is continuous due to the constant interchange between the human and environment. And this change is also innovative because of constant interchange. An open system is never exactly the same at two moments, rather than system is continuous, new or different. So Martha Roses said in Helicy, she is mentioning that open system is never exactly same at two moments. There are many differences of every moment of the open system, and the system is continuously new, otherwise new or different. Then integrality, the mutual continuous relationship of human energy field and the environmental field. This is third principle of Martha Roses' theory, hemodynamic principle, and changes occur by the continuous repatterning of human environmental field by resonance waves, and the fields are one and integrated but unique to each other. And because of inseparability of human being, the environment sequentially changes in the life process are continuous revisions occurring from interactions between human being and environment. So these are three principles, which is helicity, resonance, and integrality. So now we will discuss about the human paradigms according to Martha Roses' theory or science of unitary human being. And unity, according to Martha Roses, and unitary human being is an irreducible, indivisible, pan-dimensional, four-dimensional. Pan-dimensional means more than three-dimensional. Four-dimensional energy field identified by the pattern manifesting characteristics that are specific to the whole and which cannot be predicted from knowledge of the parts, and a unified whole having its own distinctive characteristics which cannot be perceived by looking at, describing or summarizing the parts. And a person is defined as an indivisible pan-dimensional energy field identified by a pattern or manifesting characteristic specific to whole. It cannot be predicted from the knowledge of the parts. So she's saying, according to the theory, the human being is indivisible, pan-dimensional, irreducible energy field. She mentioned the human being, likewise, not parts. She mentioning the human being as an energy field. Then second paradigm is environment. An environment is an irreducible, pan-dimensional energy field identified by the pattern and integral with the human field, and the field coexist and are integral, and manifestation emerge from this field and are perceived. So they are continuously exchanging energy. They are human and environment are continuously exchanging energy. Then the Third paradigm is health according to this SUHB theory. Rosa defined the health, the expression of the life process. They are the characteristics and behavior emerging out the mutual simultaneous interaction of the human and environmental field, and health and illness are part of same continuum. So according to the Martha Roser, this is health is the continuum, and characteristics and behavior emerging out of mutual simultaneous interaction of human and environmental field. As I told earlier about the interaction between human and environmental field, if your environment, environment is good and qualitative for the health, we will feel healthy or good. And in case we are not having the good environment, likewise we are discussing in community, this theory is generally used by the various public health or community health nurses and medicos and professionals, because they are focusing on the environment to be good for the quality life of people. And we are facing there and experiencing Swachh Bharat Abhiyan to make the environment good for the people, so that the hospital expenditure can be reduced. If environment is clear and good and safe and healthy, then hospital expenditure can be reduced. This is an initiative by the GOI, and health and illness are part of same continuum. If we are having good environment, we are healthy. If we are having bad environment, we can become ill. So health and illness are the part of the same continuum. The multiple events taking place along life axis denote the extent to which man is achieving his maximum health potential and vary in their expressions from greatest health to those conditions which are incompatible with the maintaining life process. The events vary in their expressions from greatest health to those conditions that are incompatible. Sorry, this is repetition of this point. So maintaining life process. The nursing, the last meta paradigm of the Martha Roser's theory, the two dimension independent science of nursing, an organized body of knowledge which is specific to nursing is arrived by scientific research and logical analysis, and art of nursing practice, the creative use of science for the betterment of human, and the creative use of knowledge is the art of its practice. The nursing exists to serve people. According to the Rosers, he said that nursing exists to serve people only in a creative manner. His direct and overriding responsibility to the society, the safe practice of nursing depend on the nature, amount of scientific nursing knowledge, and the individual brings to practice, the imaginative intellectual judgment with which such knowledge is made in the service to the mankind. So she emphasize on creative nursing, nursing which is having large amount of scientific knowledge, and such knowledge individual or individual nurse is brings to practice with the patient, and it can be imaginative, it can be intellectual, it can be judgmental. On so we are focusing on the higher education of nurses, because we think that if nurses having good knowledge, they are providing good care to patients, good care to patient in creative manner. So strengths of Martha Roser's theory are her concept provide a worldwide view from nurses may derive theories and hypotheses and purpose relationship specific to different situation. And some weaknesses of Martha Roser's theory are testing the concept validity is questionable because its concept are not directly measurable. Roser's claim that nursing exists to serve people, however, nurses' role were not clearly defined. The purpose of nurses is to promote health, well-being for all persons wherever they are. However, Roser's model has no concrete definition of health state. So she could not define the health in a proper manner. This is some weakness, but extraordinary. Her strength of the theory is it is a worldwide view, and in the today's era, this is more important. So I'm not going to highlight the weaknesses of her theory. I'm going to strengthening point of the Martha Roser's theory, which is provide worldwide from which nurses may derive theories. In the theory of from the theory of Martha Roser's, nurses can derive many theories. Likewise, some theories are totally related to Martha Rose's theory, like with Betty Newman's theory, like with Florence Nightingale's theory. So now we'll discuss the application, how we can apply this theory into practice. So I'm mentioning here a case description. Mrs. Rekha, a 70-year-old female, was admitted to the intensive care unit in an unresponsive state and was diagnosed to have a septicemia. She was a known case of hypertension and diabetes mellitus for 7 years, and she had right-sided hemiplegia due to stroke a year ago. She was in irregular treatment, and on admission, she was treated in ICU for 3 days and then shifted to general medical medicine ward. And in the ICU, she was drowsy, not able to verbalize her feelings, and she stares blankly, her face look anxious. She was fed through nasogastric tube, Foley's catheter was draining urine, and bowel pattern was regular. Ulcer was present on the sacral region, and she had restricted movement of right side after regaining her consciousness, and when her condition was stable, she was shifted to medical ward. In the ward, she looks more relaxed and able to tolerate fruits orally. So Mrs. Rekha was a widow residing, I'm telling her environment. Mrs. Rekha was widow residing with her son. She said, for 7 years, my son is spending a lot on my treatment. My sickness has laid burden on him and his family, and her son was very supportive and states, our mother has brought us up with a lot of difficulties, so we want to take care of her well. He added, my mother is very religious and strong enough to face the problems of life. Mrs. Rekha was treated in the hospital for 3 weeks and then discharged. On discharge, she was able to tolerate soft diet. Foley's catheter was retained. Family members were taught about the care to be taken at home, and they were referred to social workers. Mrs. Rekha was able to sit with support in bed, move her left limb, but was dependent on others for all other activities of daily living. And in the short, Mrs. Rekha is admitted in ICU with a lot of difficulties. Her son was there. And after ICU, she was shifted to medical ward, and the son was there also. And both are very concerned to each other, son and the mother. So when we start Rekha's assessment, Mrs. Rekha is a right side hemiplegic. She said, I cannot do anything of my own. I am dependent on others for everything. She tolerate only fluid and soft diet, and her intake is reduced. She has a deep bed sore over sacral region, bed sore. And her pattern is decided by the others in the hospital. She said, I am not able to mix up. This is a part of assessment of Mrs. Rekha. And she said, I am not able to mix up with others due to my condition. Because she is having bed sore, she cannot move. I feel lonely. Mrs. Rekha stated she is very religious and bold enough to face the problems of life, but now she has lost the confidence. She feels lonely and isolated. Mrs. Rekha strives hard to achieve the fullest health within her limits. So in the principle, we can apply principle of resonancy. Mrs. Rekha is on treatment. She complies with it. She stated, if I do not take these medicines, my condition may deteriorate further. She further states, my illness has laid burden on my son, but her son was very supportive. It is observed that sometimes she is pleasant, sometimes dull and withdrawn. When she was dull, she said, I feel depressed, but guilty of my illness. I do not know what will happen to the future. So she was anxious and she was worried, and she was concerned about the son, and son also concerned about the mother. So principle of Halisi applied here. Mrs. Rekha, present condition, she is under unidirectional in the moving towards achieving health within her limits. She said, I accept my illness. I may recover by using all the resources available, and I do not fear death. Her son stated, we will support and care for our mother throughout her remaining life. Then in integrity, Mrs. Rekha is hemiplegic and ready for discharge. Her family has to do some modification at home. She has to get treatment for his hypertension and diabetes mellitus also. And her son stated, I do not know how to take care of her at home and prevent any forthcoming problem. So whenever she is having that source and anxiety, everyone in the family was worried how can they taken care of the patient at home. Mrs. Rekha is on treatment. She complies with it. She stated, if I do not take these medicines, my condition may deteriorate further. She further stated, my illness has laid burden on my son. But her son is very supportive. It is observed that sometimes she is pleasant, sometimes dull and withdrawn. When she was dull, I feel depressed and guilt of my illness. I do not know what will happen in future. The application of theory, the nursing process has three steps in Roser's theory of unitary human being, which are assessment, voluntary, mutual patterning, and evaluation. So three points and three steps are there according to Roser's theory. The areas of assessment are the total pattern of events at any given point in space-time. Simultaneous stated the patient and his or her environment, rhythms of life process, supplementary data, categorical disease entities, subsystem pathology, and pattern appraisal. The assessment should be a comprehensive assessment of human and environmental field. So these are some assessment, mutual patterning of the human and environmental field include. So one is assessment, which we have done already in the Mrs. Rekha's matter, and we are here in the second stage of nursing process, mutual patterning of human field, human and environmental field includes sharing knowledge, offering choices, empowering the patient, fostering pattern and evaluation. Repeat pattern appraisal, which include nutrition, fertilizer, activities. So in this case, as we discussed, sharing knowledge. So Mrs. Rekha and the nurses or doctors can share knowledge, what she is feeling, what she has to give, offering choices. So we can give nurses and medicos can give her choices. And by the giving choices, they can empower the patient and fostering patterns. And then they can evaluate the patient. Then repeat pattern appraisal will include nutrition, which is very much important for the life of the patient, work leisure activities, which are diminished in the case of Mrs. Rekha, wake sleep cycle, relationship with son and the other family members, pain, fear, hope. And then we identify dissonance and harmony and validate appraisal with the patient and self-reflection for the patient. So nursing diagnosis in the case of Mrs. Rekha can be self-care deficit related to immobility, impaired skin integrity related to prolonged bed rest, and impaired social interaction related to activity intolerance and inability to travel to usual social activities. So there are four nursing diagnosis we can make with the above given scenario. Self-care deficit due to immobility because of she is having bed sore or decubitus ulcer in the lower region, and impaired skin integrity related to prolonged bed rest, and impaired social interaction because she cannot interact, because earlier she was social, but now when he is confined to the bed in hospital, her social interactions are diminished, and active intolerance also. So goals of nursing care is to meet the self-care needs, activity of daily living, and client maintains intact skin, and to reduce client social isolation. So we are providing self-care needs to the patient. We have to maintain intact skin integrity, and we have to reduce social isolation by offering her more activities. Then in the planning, to assist the client in meeting ADL, provide constant encouragement, provide family support, and to treat bed sore, to relieve pressure on the bed sore, we can use many devices to relieve bed sore. We can provide back care, we can provide frequent change of motions, we can provide frequent change of positions, and assist her in maintaining hygiene, and educate the family members. Educate the family members about the care, about the positions, about the back care, about the diminishing social isolation, about giving her time, and assist social life of family provide diversion therapy like which is she is having interest, likewise music, likewise watching movies, listening music, and talking to the family members. So we can provide the the diversion therapy and listen to the client's problems or complaints. So this is the part of planning. Then I'm not going to implementing. And then how we can evaluate the patient according to Rose's theory, clients carrying out the activities within her limits, family members are assisting and encouraging her. So, and the next evaluation, Batsor is getting healed, family members understood the interaction given and then implementing them, and client verbalize that she feel good, family members verbalize that they feel help the client to minimize her social isolation. So addressing problem in nursing, according to Martha Roser, Roser's model is useful for addressing the issues of nursing burnout. Nursing staff burnout is one of the main obstacles to effectively maintaining a culture of safety, which is a set of shared values, beliefs, norms, and processes related to patient safety among members of an organization, according to Weber et al. In 2013. Many nurses, while supporting in safety culture, end up compromising it due to being overworked. Some nurses, for example, work two full-time jobs at separate facilities, which leads to exhaustion. The more stressed and tired a nurse become, the more likely mistakes are. Burnout is a condition that occurs when stress becomes so bad that it creates a kind of malaise. Though nurses may know that focus is important for the job, when experiencing burnout, simply cannot find the motivation to keep focus. Nurses' burnout adds to anxiety and at-risk behavior in workplace and poor patient-nurse communication. Nursing burnout may lead to poor decision making, example, cohorting delirious patients with frail elderly, or in this era of COVID-19, we are facing the burnouts. Every nurse, today newspaper I read that one nursing staff is bow in front of CMHO that I am working continuous on 28 days and now I want to go home, but my HOD is not providing me leave. And he was crying in front of the chief medical officer, and they are helpless to give him leave. So this burnout is common in this area, in this era, and we are feeling using PPE kit, using overburden hours, using continuous duty hours, we are feeling burnout. So Martha Roser's theory can help us in coping up this burnout. So concluding, the work of Martha Roser has been an important contribution to the nursing community, both for its reframing of the scope of work being done and for its emphasis on scientific process needed to address the problems facing nursing. It emphasizes both the importance of individual as well as the connections that individual has to the environment and society as a whole. It presents human being as being more than sum of their whole. At the same time, Roser's theory advocates for an empirical approach to the problems facing nursing. Roser's work can be supplemented by the Newman's when addressing nursing burnout. This creates a clear chain of action that must be accomplished to maintain a culture of safety that starts with identifying nurses as a part of the clinical environment and ends with the reducing stressor to patient that would result from nursing burnout. So I use these references for the presentation. This is Roser's and Hector's and Sapphire's books. And thank you very much for active listening. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. You have explained the entire theory in very simple words. Now I request the participant that if you have any questions, you can type in your question and answer box, so that soon we can ask madam on your questions. If anybody is having any type of questions, please.
May I ask one question, Itesh, from the audience?
Sure, ma'am, sure.
Okay, so I hope there are PG students in the audience. So are they feeling theories are very complicated for them. They are not having interest because in India we are not having any theorist. So how they are feeling about theories? I would like to ask audience, from the audience, how they feel about theories, how can they cope up with the theories? Yeah, they are reading theories according for the question and for the exam purpose, or they indulge in the theory to learn theory. So this is my question from the audience. Anyone of the audience? Anyone from the audience?
Anybody want to answer madam's question?
When is writing that reading theory is easy for me, but application of theory is very difficult for me.
Reply from Vijita Vini. One reply is there, ma'am. Reading theory is easy.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Application of theory is very
difficult. Thank you, Vinita. Thank you, Vijita Vini, for the responding my question. Theory is easy because you're saying theory is easy. But why not we are creating any theories from India? Application is according to theory. They are setting some meta paradigm, and every theory having four meta paradigm, which is health, nurses, environment, and patient. So according every theorist define the meta paradigm according to themselves. So difficulty is not so big. You have to apply the theory. You have to define the theory, define all the meta paradigm according to the particular theorist. Likewise, in Martha Rose's theory, they are saying human are not human. They are pan-dimensional and they are energy field only. So we have to maintain that energy in the field. We are connecting the environment. In case our environment is bad, then energy field is low. So we cannot cope. We cannot provide patient a comfortable zone. Then, if patient environment is good, he or she can full of energy and he can revive and he can maintain her health or his health early. So you can apply theory with a set of meta paradigm, which is every theorist defined. The next question is, any anonymous attendee, Nitesh ji, one is anonymous attendee is there. So how to define meta paradigm according to different theorists? My dear anonymous attendee, you need not to define meta paradigm. Theorists already define the meta paradigm according to them. So you have to memorize the theorist, and in case you want to define, you are going to make a theory. You are going to set a theory. So you need not to define the theory. How to remember? Very good. How to remember? In my PG programs, when I was in my master's, I made a chart of every theorist. For 15 theorists, I wrote Julia B. George book that. And we all batchmates made a chart. And in the one column, we wrote name of theories, and another columns we set meta paradigm according to different authors. And you need not to memorize. You need not to memorize. You just remind Martha Rose's energy field, Betty Newman's goal of King's goal, then Oram's self care model. So you need not to just remember the name and meta paradigm. You can apply the theory. No problem. Anyone else?
Ma'am, Sandhya Kumari has written that we struggle to fit in our life anyhow.
Sandhya, I don't have the Sandhya. I had Renu Bala Pradhan. Knowingly or unknowingly, we are applying the theory only.
One more reply is there, ma'am. Applying theories in PG while writing nursing process is very interesting. If we could follow the section of assessment and evaluation. So ma'am, please explain regarding the assessment section according to a particular theory like subjective data, how a student should write, and about objective data.
Okay. So I can apply my theory only, which is given by you, Gopal, to me. In the theory of Martha Roses, we are assessing the patient, assessing the energy field of patient, energy field and environment. So in this, I gave a case study of Mrs. Rekha, which is admitted earlier to ICU. The ICU environment is different. So we have to assess the Mrs. Rekha in ICU and ICU in an environment. Then she shifted to medical ward ultimately, and the environment has been changed and she feel good in the medical ward. So this is assessment of environment only, assessment of energy field. In the Martha Roses theory, when you are going to assess the patient, this is assessment of environment and assessment of energy field. So it can be done according to the theorist. Then Renu Bala Pradhan is asking, knowingly, unknowingly, we are applying the theory only. So I don't get you, Ms. Renu Bala. Knowingly, unknowingly, you have to apply theory to pass your examination in India. This is scenario, especially in North India. So we are applying theory only. We are not applying theory. In case we are applying theory, we can modify any theory as the earlier theorist done, and we are just reading theory for exam purpose. Agreed, Mr. Nitesh? Agreed.
Ma'am, one message is there through chat box.
Okay.
It's saying that.
So should I see the chat box? In
clinical setup.
Where is chat box here?
Chat box is there, ma'am. Just side of question and answer box. Chat box is there. Just the side of question and answer box, ma'am.
Okay. New share. Participant stop video chat box. I don't get the chat box. Okay. Yes, I got it. Mm-hmm. So, I think theory studies should start from GNM program itself. During clinical practice, we are facing all the theories, but if no, the theory can perform well while taking care of patient. It is my personal opinion, madam. Actually, you don't know, we are started theories in GNM. Now, they have their theories in their syllabus. So we started theory from GNM, but they are feeling so complicated, the theories. So they are not having interest, and they're skipping the questions of theories. They're not having interest. So we have to make them interesting. Theories teaching must be interesting. Theories teaching must be effective. And so one is the next one question. Applying theories in PG while writing nursing process. This is Limpokam Ranjita. Applying theories in PG while writing nursing process is very interesting if we could follow the section of assessment and evaluation. So ma'am, please explain regarding the assessment section according to the particular. Okay, we took the caution already.
Already over.
And ma'am, any? Okay, over. So, which is next question, Chikanji? All questions are over. Okay. Thank you so much. In case you have any questions, you can contact Nitinji or myself for the theories. We are happy to help you regarding theories. And I will be so happy if I receive your questions.
Thank you so much, ma'am. At last, I would like to thank all the participants for your active listening, and you have raised your genuine questions to the panelist, madam. I would like to thank madam for sharing beautiful presentation and giving appropriate answer to all the questions of participant. At last, I would like to thank that team of administration of NTAI who have really done beautiful work by arranging such type of session. In means this is the first time I am looking that topic wise sessions are going on, And thank to Manish sir that who have given us the platform to talk to all the nursing fraternity. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, Nitesh ji. Thank you, Farooq sir, for giving me this opportunity. And I am hoping that in future, NTAI will arrange the series of this type of sessions to help the nursing students pan India. Or I wish for your better future. I wish for your empowerment, and I want to see you on the top of the associations of Indian nursing. So thank you
thanks
so
a lot,
much.
Ma'am. Yeah, thanks a lot, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Thanks for your lovely wishes. And I hope so we will do the work hard under your expert and under the supervision. Really, if you will provide us the way, we will go for upside only. Yeah, really, thanks a lot, ma'am. And thank you, Nitesh sir, for excellent moderation. And thank you, Samta ma'am, a excellent presentation today, really.
Thank you so much.
In interactive way, you have explained the theory, because theory are the very complicated to understand. But you have made the way to understand very easily. Really, it is very nice session. And in future also, I hope that you will support us to do other thing also. And your guidance, I hope that your guidance will continue for the Nursing Teacher Association. Thanks a lot, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Happy Independence to all of us. Thank you so much. And see you soon in the next series of NTAI. Thank you so much.